Tammy Dunbar here. One of the problems we've noticed is that when we get into a meeting with students, they can only see the last four people who have been speaking, and it's very distracting when we're trying to be the main focus. Now, there's a workaround, and see what you think. If you click on Meet Now to go into a meeting, make sure your video camera is first turned off. I'll show you why in a moment. Now I'm going to join my meeting with my camera turned off, but my sound going. Perfect. So what I'm going to do is go up to the top right-hand corner, and I'm going to shrink the screen just a little bit. Not totally, but just a little bit. I'm going to move it over there on the right-hand side. Then I'm going to go down to the bottom. Kids are talking to each other, getting ready to start. And I'm going to open up my camera app. Why? Because they're just going to see me in a moment. So you can see me now. Now I'm going to slide this over just a little so I can see that. Perfect. And now I'm going to share my screen. And I'm going to share my desktop. And I'm going to say, all right, students, check this out. Mrs. Dunbar is going to be talking to you today. And now that I've shared the screen, they can't see each other. All they can see is me on my camera, and they can hear me because I left the microphone turned on in Teams. I also have both of these shrunken so that I can see who's in the meeting so I can get to that all-important mute button if I need it, right? And if I need to go back to the meeting, if I'm done giving direct instruction, then all I have to do is click in this bottom corner, right? Click here to go back to the call screen, and I just have to click on this. And now I'm back in here and I can stop sharing my screen so they can work together. That is how easy it is to have you on the screen. Play this several times and reach out to me if you have a question.